Amen. Prayer and fasting. Been doing a lot of that recently, and I want to encourage you once again tonight. Amen. Before I speak, fasting, your routine is broken up and your focus is given to God. Amen. It brings change to your life. Have you noticed that? More sensitive to the voice of God, more sensitive to His Spirit. Fasting is restricting food for a spiritual purpose. Not my purpose, but His purpose. Amen. Praise God. Setting ourselves apart in this new year to draw closer to God. Amen. There's benefits to fasting. Just want to encourage you tonight. Just want to keep adding to it. Benefits to the body. Benefits to the soul. Amen. Praise God. There is a blessing as the church prays and fasts together. I have noticed it. I've seen it. I've heard the testimonies. God's doing wonderful things. Amen. Praise God. There's power in prayer and fasting. It brings out a deeper, abiding relationship with God. Amen. Continue. Be encouraged. Amen. It's going to be worth it. Amen. Praise God. I want us to turn to Matthew chapter 28 and verse 19 and Mark chapter 1 verse 14. I want to talk to you tonight about personal evangelism, about soul winning. Been doing a lot of praying and fasting. We're going to keep doing it. Amen. But this church, it's the will of God for it to grow and to multiply. I've seen some great things happen in the year and a half that I've pastored this church. Amen. With my family, we've witnessed great things. Amen. But there's no reason to stop where we're at and say, this is good. There's still empty chairs. Amen. It's the will of God. Amen. For this place to be filled every service. Praise God. We've got to go, church. Go, ye therefore, and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Praise God. So thankful that I know the name of the Father, and the name of the Son, and the name of the Holy Ghost. So glad I know the name of the one that was on the cross. His name is Jesus. Amen. So glad I've been baptized in the name of Jesus, and not just the titles. Amen. It's imperative that we do that. It's the Word of God. Amen. John 1:14. Now after that John was put in prison, Jesus came to Galilee, preaching the gospel of the kingdom of God. He came preaching the kingdom of God. Mark 1:14. He did not come selling Amway. He did not come to build a fan base. Jesus came, the scripture says, preaching the gospel of what? The kingdom. Amen. Advancing His kingdom and saying, the time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent ye and believe the gospel. Now as He walked by the Sea of Galilee, He saw Simon and Andrew, His brother, casting a net into the sea, for they were fishers. And Jesus said unto them, come ye after me, and I will make you to become fishers of men. You need to stop and forget about the sheephead and the grouper and the mullet and whatever else is out there. I want you to be fishermen of men. Amen. Praise God. And straightway, the Bible says they forsook their nets and followed Him. They forsook their nets. Imagine that. Quit their jobs, their livelihood, and just started following Jesus. What faith? Disciples. Amazing. Jesus said, come ye after me, and I will make you to become fishers of men. They forsook their nets. They followed Him. When He had gone a little further, He saw James, son of Zebedee, and John, his brother, and also were in the ship mending their nets. And straightway He called them, and they left their father Zebedee in the ship with the hired servants and went after Him. Go. It's time to go. Everybody say, I want to go. Go ye therefore. God help us tonight, Jesus, to be challenged from Your Word. Speak to us, Jesus. We want to make a difference in this city that You've called us, Lord. To be a witness in, Lord. There's so many people that are hurting, so many people that are bound with addictions and problems, family problems, marriage problems, drugs, alcohol. It's in this city, God. I pray that You would help us to go and to be a witness, to love people, Lord. In the name of the Lord, let the anointing flow tonight. Speak to us. Challenge our hearts. And everybody said, in Jesus' name, praise God. Turn to somebody tonight and tell them, it's time for you to go, bud. Praise God. Amen. If you said go, you may be seated. Praise God. You can stand up or you can be seated, like Brother Herbert said Sunday morning. Praise God. Follow me and I will make you fishers of men. I have a responsibility as the pastor of this church to feed the sheep. That's what I'm doing right now. Everybody open your mouth. I'm feeding the sheep. Amen. Praise God. I love doing it. It's what I'm called to do. It's a part of ministry. However, I can preach the greatest messages. Amen. I can hear great job, pastor. But no one will be converted if there are no lost people in this sanctuary. Praise God. We must go. There has to be souls here that are hungry for the Word of God. Amen. We've heard a lot of good preaching and teaching over the years if you've been in church for a while. Amen. But we are called to go. Amen. I'm called to preach, but I'm also called to win souls. It's the will of God. Amen. For me to be a soul winner. Proverbs. Amen. Mentions this scripture. Amen. I believe it's Proverbs 11 and verse 30. The fruit of the righteous is a tree of life, and he that winneth souls is wise. Amen. There's nothing dumb about being a soul winner. Amen. You got to be in tune with God's Spirit. Amen. You got to be led of the Spirit. Amen. He that winneth souls is wise. God, help me tonight to be a wise man. I'm called to win souls, to reach out to people, to go. Amen. It's time to go. We've laid a great foundation in this, well, in 2013. A lot of prayer, fasting. Amen. In this new year, we're doing the same thing. We're laying a foundation. Amen. Amen. Of prayer and fasting. The Bible says to do that. First of all, we are to pray. Amen. It's the first thing that we need to do. Before we have church, before we do anything, we must pray to God. Amen. Praise God. But now it's time to advance the kingdom. Amen. Anybody heard that recently? It's our vision. It's our dream for the new year. For God to advance his kingdom in St. Petersburg. Anybody believe it can happen? I really do. I believe it can happen. Amen. Praise God. We will continue with inreach. And that's what we're doing here tonight. There's an inreach that's going on in the four walls of this sanctuary. But it's time for outreach. Amen. It's time to go forth. Evangelist Tim Green, he's coming Sunday night. We need to reach out. We need to invite people that have no clue about the gospel. Amen. Those that are hungry and thirsty that need Jesus, it's time to go. It's time to smile. It's time to be a witness. Amen. Praise God. If we're going to be a witness, we've got to have the joy of the Lord. They're not going to come to your church if you're frowning at the checkout line. If you're mumbling and grumbling about how long the line is or how slow the gas pump is. Come on, somebody. Amen. If we're going to go, amen. What we have is the Holy Ghost. Amen. What we have is the truth. We might as well tell somebody about it with the joy of the Lord. Praise God. Saturday is a prime opportunity. Outreach or reach out. You can say it both ways, but it both means that we're going to go. We're going to go and tell somebody about the Life Center, about this great church. Amen. There's a van that's coming soon. I believe it by faith. There's a chart in the back. The red line's going up. The barometer's going up. Amen. Why do we need a church van? Praise God. We need it to be filled with Sunday school children. Amen. I believe it's going to happen, so let's get to work. Jesus came to Galilee, Mark 1:14, preaching the gospel of the kingdom. Amen. Once again, he wasn't promoting other things. He wasn't promoting his latest book that he had written. Amen. How to win souls. How to influence people. Amen. Jesus came, the Bible says, preaching the gospel. He didn't come with an idea with a franchise to start Krispy Kreme donuts in Galilee. Amen. Shouldn't have mentioned that. Praise God. Where'd that come from? Praise God. We're advancing his kingdom. Amen. Praise God. Sorry about that. It's time to go. It's time to get up. There's nothing more powerful than an apostolic praying church. Amen. We heard that message last week via DVD by Brother Cunningham. Amen. It spurred me to go. Amen. To be a witness. Praise God. You may say, well, I can't go. Let me read you a scripture tonight that should remind us all that we have the benefit. When God fills you with the Holy Ghost, when you speak in tongues, He gives you the power to be a witness. Everybody say power. And you shall receive what? Acts 1:8. You shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. And you shall be witness unto me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea and in Samaria and into the uttermost part of the earth. Let me rephrase that tonight. You shall be witness unto me both in St. Petersburg and in Florida and the United States of America and the world. Amen. We have the power. It's the same Holy Ghost that Peter had. It is. Hadn't changed. There's still power when it comes. What do you want to do when you're saved? I mean, you want to tell people about it, don't you? You would not believe what happened at the Life Center. I went into that place. Something happened to me. Let me tell you about my experience. Amen. I repented of my sins. God washed them away. I was baptized in the name of Jesus in a watery grave. Amen. God filled me with the Holy Ghost. Anybody remember your testimony? There's power in your testimony. Amen. You shall receive power if the Holy Ghost has come upon you. Amen. You shall be witnesses. Amen. Not couch potatoes. Doesn't say professional Christians. You shall be witnesses. Amen. Oh, I can't do that, Pastor. I'm kind of shy. I don't know. That's a little rough for me. I'm embarrassed. I'm afraid. You've got the power. You've got the power. Amen. Starts by handing out a card to somebody at Target. You need to come to the Life Center. Amen. You need to come to church with me. It'll brighten your day. Amen. Praise God. You may be afraid, but you know what? You've got to go. There's a call on everybody's heart. We've got to go. Amen. Praise God. We've got to pray. We've got to fast. Amen. Your neighborhood needs to hear about Jesus. Amen. It's time to go. It's time to get up. Jesus was on the go coming into Galilee. You read the Gospels. He was always with people. He was criticized by the Pharisees and the Sadducees, by sitting with sinners, going out amongst them. Jesus, He just kept doing it. Amen. Amen. He had a mindset that said, I'm going. Amen. I'm going to reach this world. He has come to seek and to save that which is lost. Amen. Do you have a lost loved one in your family? Jesus has come to save them. Amen. You have a lost neighbor in your neighborhood? God has come to save them. Amen. Praise God. There's a better life for them. Tell somebody about it. Get up and go. You got to move. You go somewhere, you got to get up. Amen. You got to start your car up. You got to jump on your 10 speed. You got to jump on your motorbike, your moped. A lot of mopeds in this city. Amazing. Praise God. People are on the go. Amen. You've got to get up and you've got to go if you're going to get somewhere. It works the same way with advancing the kingdom of God. You got to get up and go. You got to get up and go to prayer meeting. You got to get up and go. You've come here tonight because there's action. Praise God. You have the power of go. It's a dangerous movement that messes with the devil's kingdom. All of this action, all of this talk about prayer and fasting, I think the devil's getting frustrated. What in the world are they doing? They're always showing up at the church. Don't you think it's messing with his mind and his kingdom? Amen. I'm going to keep on doing it. Amen. Praise God. Prayer and fasting intensifies our efforts. It opens the right doors and leads us to the right families that are hungry for truth, that have tried everything else. Amen. This world still can't satisfy. It's only Jesus that can satisfy your soul. Amen. We got to go. Praise God. There's people that are hungry for truth. Can I say we have a beautiful new sign out there? Isn't it awesome? It's a beautiful thing. Amen. It's lit up like a lighthouse on 62nd Avenue. You can see it. I can see it as I turn on the intersection. I see, there it is. There's the new sign. Amen. Sanctified, proud of that sign. Amen. Praise God. It equals visitors. Amen. Praise God. What are we promoting here at this church? Through the website. There was a couple that came to church this past Sunday morning that found us on the internet. Praise God. Wonderful tool. Being a witness. Amen. Praise God. But can I tell you that we cannot depend on just the new church sign? We cannot depend just on the internet for people looking for a Pentecostal church. Amen. I believe it's time for us to get up and to go. Amen. Amen. There's a certain percentage that are going to come through the sign, through the website, and for you going forth and saying, I'm going to be involved in outreach. Amen. It's about evangelism. It's about reaching your neighborhood. It's about reaching your family. Praise God. This is not a pyramid scheme. Amen. You don't have to pay $1,000 to get into this wonderful gospel. Amen. Praise God. You don't. Amen. You just got to come to the Lord and give your life to Him. Amen. Oh, sure, there's a price tag. Amen. But God is going to do the work through us. Amen. Evangelism, it's personal. It's our neighborhood. It's our city. Go, Brother Nathan. Go, Brother Moorfield. Go, Brother Heaven. Praise God. Your mouth, your voice, and your testimony is still the most powerful tool that God can use in your own little world. Bree has a little world, amen? She does. Brother Chris Rose has a little world. They know people that I don't know. That's right. Praise God. Brother Wayne Jordan has people in his little world. Amen? There's a neighborhood. There's a group of friends that I don't know. Amen. You have a mission field is what I'm getting at. It's time to go. Amen. Praise God. The action, it's out there. If we will do our part, God will do His at the altar. Just pick up your fishing gear. It's time to pick up the Zebcos and the pin rod. Amen. The trilene. Amen. The strand line. Amen. The hooks. It's time to go forth. Amen. Come on, Jesse. Help me out tonight. It's time to go fishing. Amen. Praise God. You know, there's a very powerful law about outreach. Here's the way it works with God. I've seen it in every church that I've been a part of since I was knee-high to a grasshopper. This is the way it works. You go to outreach. You pass out flyers. You knock on doors. You invite people to church. Many times I've noticed, hey, nobody in that neighborhood showed up to church. But then I've looked up and I've said, you know what? Where did they come from? Where did that family come from? There is a law, amen, amen, if you will cast the seed out, amen, if you will cast out the bread on the water, it's going to come back, amen. If we will do our part, it may not be the door that you knock on, it may not be the lady at the checkout line at Target, but somebody's coming, because God takes notice when a church gets up and goes. It works. Don't be discouraged. Amen. It's amazing how God works. Just go. God will move on the hearts of the lost. Amen. He loves people. Jesus loved being around people. He still does. Amen. It's the will of God. Amen. For the Lord to be lifted up in this church. Amen. No time for patty cake for Jesus. Amen. I'm serious about this. Don't ever stop reaching out to other people. It's time to go. Keep passing out those church cards. I always have them in my wallet. I get upset when I run out and I'm talking to somebody else. I don't have a card. Try to tell them where it's at. Amen. Keep those cards in your purse, ladies. Keep the cards in your wallets. Amen. Invite them to church. Amen. We've got the invite cards out in the foyer. They're in the back. Amen. The address is on them. Take them with you. Amen. It's time to go. When's the last time you told somebody in your neighborhood about your church? It's time to go. It's time to wake up and to tell them, because if we don't, somebody else will. Somebody that doesn't promote the full gospel of Jesus Christ. We've got to go, church. The Acts is filled with action. It doesn't talk about a bunch of dead saints that got the Holy Ghost and just passed out and said, that's it. The Bible is filled. Amen. Acts chapter 2, there's a word that caught my attention today. I've read it. It always inspires me. It says that they continued. Acts 1:14, these all continued. Amen? Not going on cruises, not going on fishing trips. No, the Bible says that they continued steadfast in the apostles' doctrine. Acts 2 and 42, they continued steadfastly. Amen? Acts 2, 46, they continued daily in reaching souls. Not just Saturday morning at 10 o'clock, but daily. Praise God. You don't always have to open your mouth to be a witness. They're going to notice the way that you talk. They're going to notice the way that you dressed in your modest apparel. Not like the world. Amen. They're going to notice there's something different about that brother John Fox. I can't figure it out. Amen. There's something that they notice about our young ladies in a public school. Amen. About our young men that are saying, I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to be addicted to that. Just live the life. Amen. It's the first step to being a witness. If you will just go. Amen. If you will just strive to serve the Lord, the seed will be planted without you even opening your mouth. It's the word of God. Amen. Anybody believe this tonight? Praise God. Praise God. Some of you look a little stunned tonight. Amen. It's in the word of God. Amen. We've got to go. Praise God. Matthew 4 and 18. Praise God. Praise God. Everybody love the word of God tonight? Praise God. Jesus, walking by the Sea of Galilee, saw two brethren, Simon called Peter and Andrew, his brothers, casting a net into the sea, for they were fishers. And he said unto them, follow me, and I will make you fishers of men. Follow me. Praise God. Who you following tonight? Amen. I want to be following Jesus. Amen. Praise God. The Bible says that straightway and immediately they follow Jesus. Verse 20, they straightway, praise God, we've got to straightway follow Jesus. We get caught up in the cares of life. Can I tell you, you can't go if you get all of this baggage. If you've got a schedule that has no room for God, you will have no room for outreach. It's simply put, amen. What's stopping you from going? What's stopping you from being a witness? We've got to go straight forward. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. He called them, verse 21, and they immediately left the ship and their father and followed him. The Bible doesn't say that they stopped and said, Jesus, hang on a second. We've got to clean the boat off real quick. Amen. There's a lot of salt on it. Been fishing all night. A lot of fish heads here. We've got to clean this up. Before I go, before I follow you. No, the Bible says that immediately they left the ship and their father and they followed him. Praise God. Go. Straightway. Go. Immediately. Amen. Amen. There's no time to think about this. I don't know when Jesus is coming, but you know what? I want to do my part. I don't want to become busy. I don't want to be distracted. I just want to go. I want to be on track. Amen. I want to continue as the apostles did. Praise God. Praise God. We started a church several years ago in St. Louis, Missouri. Amen. A lot of outreach. Amen. I remember going out and passing cards one Saturday and there was a family that showed up Sunday morning. Yeah. Amen. That is awesome. Amen. Somebody came to church because of the outreach. Amen. This is awesome. And I remember going up to that young man, introducing myself to him as the pastor, amen, of the church there. And amen, I always say, well, how did you hear about us? Amen. He told me not what I really expected. He said this. He said, I was at my friend's house. And he said, I was walking in the kitchen. And he said, I looked on the refrigerator. And he said, I saw one of your flyers that had your church name and your information. Amen. We live in the area. We're looking for a new church, and we decided to come here today. Isn't that amazing? Amen. Praise God. The person that we knocked on the door, the person that we handed the flyer to, they didn't come to church, but somebody that was looking for 2% milk, amen, they came to church. A friend, amen, of the family. Isn't that the way God works? You never know how God's going to do it, but He will bring them. But we've got to go and do our part. Praise God. That'll fire anybody up, amen? You never know who's going to see it. You never know who's going to hear it. They will come. Praise God. I was passing out cards during the Pinellas Park Christmas parade. Amen. Some people thought I was a little bit crazy. I was handing them church cards, amen? Somebody mentioned before we left, I saw a lot of the church cards on the floor, on the ground. The wind was blowing them. Amen. That's okay. Amen. You never know the person cleaning up the parade the next day may dig in the trash and pick up a card. Amen. Come through those doors and kneel down in an altar and find Jesus. Amen. It's what it's all about. Don't question it. Just go. Praise God. New experiences. It keeps us fresh and alive. Amen. There's no greater joy in serving God than telling somebody about Jesus and inviting them, calling them, witnessing them at work, and see them walk through the door of the church, come to an altar of repentance. There is no greater joy. Praise God, I've had some happy moments in my walk with God, but that tops them all. Amen. To be a soul winner. Amen. Praise God. I remember the first young man that I won to the Lord, working with him. Amen. Witnessing to him. He eventually came to church. Amen. The music started. And I remember sitting by Joe, amen, in San Diego, California, and looking over at him, tears streaming down his face. Amen. Starting to sob uncontrollable. Amen. I was thinking, what in the world's wrong with him? Amen. It was the love of Jesus that he was feeling. Amen. Praise God. It was an amazing thing to see him walk to the altar that night. Amen. To lift his hands and to repent and receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. There was no greater joy that night. That fired me up. And you know what it did to me? It made me want to go out and go fishing again and tell somebody else what the Lord had done for Joe Nunez, what God had done in my life. Amen. Praise God. New experiences will keep you fresh and happy in the service of the Lord. Quit depending on that testimony from 1977. Amen. You need a new experience. Amen. You need to go. Amen. You need to open your mouth. Amen. You need to witness to somebody something fresh. It will change your life. It will give you newness. Does anybody believe this tonight? It will change your life. Praise God. Go! Why? Because you are empowered. Amen. You are empowered tonight. Praise God. You have the power. You're called. Go. Souls are looking. Souls are waiting. Amen. Go. Get up and get active. Action. Go. Praise God. Tonight, I want to do my part. Amen. Praise God. We have the power. Amen. You're walking around this city like with a piece of dynamite in your hand. You really are, spiritually. Some of us don't realize the power that we have within our hands, amen? Some of us needs to find a flame, amen, and light that piece of dynamite, amen, and let it explode the gospel all over your neighborhood, the shrapnel of truth. It needs to embed into the hearts of people in this city. You have the power to be a witness. What are you going to do with it? We've got to go, amen? Praise God. Praise God. Sunday school, how's it going to happen? We've prayed about it. We've fasted about it. Now let's go. Saturday morning, 10 o'clock. Let's go, amen? The youth are going to go. This youth group is going to grow, amen? They're going to pray. They're going to fast. They're going to continue having youth services. But they're going to go, amen? Praise God. Families, young and old, you can go. Praise God. If you're not physically able, pick up the telephone. Amen. It's an amazing thing what you can do on Facebook for the good. Amen. Tell people about your church. Be a witness. Just go. Be men and women of action. Praise God. Get off the chair and go. Let's take it to the outside and let's advance His kingdom. Praise God. There's no room for a lack attack. That's right. There's no room for a lack attack. There's not going to be a lack of truth in this church, in this neighborhood, in this city. Amen? Praise God. I don't need a lack attack. I've got to go. There's no lack of power. We've got all the power that we need. We've got to use it. We've got to activate it for the kingdom of God. Skeptics don't show up for outreach. Those that are cynical, they stay home, super glued to the couch. Amen? Doubters debate the reason of even going out and knocking doors and talking to people in the first place. Nobody's going to respond. Somebody's going to be rude to me. Somebody's going to hurt my feelings. You don't understand, Pastor. I'm a sensitive person. Have you ever heard that before? Amen. We've got to go. I've had a lot of doors slammed in my face. I've had people say, you know what, I don't want to hear it. Please get off my property. You know what? If they don't want the gospel, there's somebody in that neighborhood that does. Amen. Don't be sensitive. Just keep plowing forward. Amen. Reach out. Go. Praise God. I believe it's the will of God to blitz everybody's neighborhood. Keep talking about this church. We need to get in your neighborhood. The people know that you're a Pentecostal in your apartment complex, in your housing division. It's time for us to go. Amen. Chinese proverb, I've read it before. If your vision is for a year, plant wheat. If your vision is for 10 years, plant trees. If your vision is for a lifetime, plant people. Every soul counts. Every seed, it matters. Amen. Every time you open your mouth and tell somebody about Jesus, amen, you're simply doing what He did. Jesus got up and He went to Galilee and He went fishing. Praise God. We got to go. Sister Rabel, your neighborhood, they need to know about this Pentecostal experience. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Brother Jack, they need to know about your experience in your neighborhood. We've got to go. Praise God. It's not all about knocking doors. We got to think big. I want to go on a big fishing adventure. Used to catch those little perch when I was a little kid about that big. It's kind of fun for a few times, but you know what? I was there for the big fish, amen? For the big bass, amen? The big catfish, amen? Anybody here for the big catch? Praise God. Every soul counts. We've got to go, and we've got to go fishing, amen? Jesus told the disciples, you need to cast your nets on the other side. Fished all night and caught no fishes. Fished all night and caught no fishes. Remember that old one? Sunday school. Fished all night and caught no fishes. Praise God. Jesus said, you know what? You're fishing on the wrong side. You need to cast your net on the other side. But Lord, that's hard work. We've got the nets out. You know how hard it is to bring them back to the boat? To position the boat just right and to pull them up and to get them on the other side. Amen. Can I say, serving the Lord and being a soul winner, amen, it takes a little bit of work, amen. There's extra energy and effort. You've got to go. It's inconvenient because, you know what? I don't really want to go fishing this morning. I'd rather go to the circus. Praise God. You've got to go, amen. If you go to the circus, make sure you take your church cards with you, amen. Tell them about the Life Center, the greatest show on earth. Praise God, it'll blow your mind. Talk about power. Woo! Praise God. Praise God. God, take away the hindrances in our life. Praise God. What is the biggest hindrance to this church? Think about it tonight. What is hindering us from growing leaps and bounds? Amen. We already have a parking problem. I welcome that. We'll work that out on Sunday mornings. But I want to have a parking problem on Wednesday night. And Sunday night and Friday night. I want this place to be filled with young people. Amen. That come to this place. Where do we park? I'd like to go to church, but your parking lot is full. You know what? We'll work it out. Amen. Praise God. What an awesome problem to have. I want to grow. I want to see God multiply this church. If you feel that way, would you lift your hands right now and say, Lord, I want to do my part. God, help me to get out of this rut. I know I've been praying and fasting. You're dealing with my heart, Jesus. But I got to get up and I got to go. I got to do my part, Jesus. Praise God. Praise God. In 1900, it said it was the largest church of that city. It doesn't say where this was. I read this story today. But it said by 1959, it was deserted and boarded up. For 2 years, there had been not one service in this church. The church had literally died. At the turn of the century, an average Sunday in this church had seen 800 people come to worship God. Through the years, this elite church in one of the nicest residential areas of the city began to go down and to die. The wealthy people moved away and poor people came in. Soon many Hispanic Americans were moving in too, all different races. And the denomination itself became alarmed about the condition of this famous church. Several very intensive programs were launched to bring it back to life, but nothing succeeded. The grand old building, it finally lay empty. But in 1959, there was a young preacher that came to the city who claimed the call of God upon his life. He was just a young man who was 24 years old. He was enthusiastic and optimistic. You could almost call him immature. But he found, as he came to that city and he looked at that church and he researched it, he found that there were only 7 members that were left in the church. 24 years old, a pastor, calling upon his heart, was 7 members. He got them together and he announced, "I want to be your pastor. Would you vote me in?" And sure enough, they did. The first step that he took is he went to a Hispanic orphanage nearby and arranged to have the little children come to the church there on Sunday morning to worship. Soon, he was running over 50 in Sunday school. Over 50 children, orphans, the 7 members and his family, pushing it over 50 members. He held a soul winners conference at his church for those members of his church, all 7 of them and his family. The story said the scene was unique, a magnificent old building which would easily seat 1,000 people. And there on the front row, there was 10 Christians that were learning how to win souls. The meeting closed on Friday. Amen. And 4 Sundays later, that little church had gone from an attendance of 50 people to an attendance of over 220 people. What was the difference? Somebody said, "I'm going to go. And I'm going to do my part. I know I've been praying. I know I've been fasting. But it's time for me to get up. And it's time for me to go." Amen? Praise God. We're at a crossroads here at the Life Center. Do we stay the same size? Or do we get up and do we say, "I'm going to go and I'm going to do my part. I want to see revival. I want to see this place expand." Church, if there ever was a time for us to get up and to go, it's right now. Praise God. Revival is here. Let's stand tonight. Praise God. Will anybody go? God forbid that this church has the same ending, where the doors were shut, lights turned off, the church was pronounced dead. I don't believe that's the will of God for any church. But it happens when there is a spiritual death that happens inside the walls of the church, when we forget about the Great Commission, and we forget about the scripture that says we have to go, amen, to do our part. Praise God. Praise God. Would you pray tonight and ask God to speak to you about getting up and going forth to be a witness? God, help us tonight, Jesus, to be sensitive to your Spirit. God, in your name, it's happened generation after generation. Churches that shrivel up and die, and then someone comes along with a vision and a desire, Lord, to see it grow and multiply. If it happened in 1959 at this great church, Lord, I believe that it can happen here in 2014 here at the Life Center. God, we know that this church has been through a whole lot in the past few years, Lord. A lot of different setbacks. Lord Jesus, disappointments in life. But Lord, you've called us to this place for such a time as this. We stand at the crossroads tonight, Lord, right in the middle of prayer and fasting. And I pray tonight that there would be a response from somebody in this church that would say, "Lord, I'm going to go and I'm going to do my part." Praise God. This altar is open tonight to anybody that needs salvation, that needs to repent, amen, to receive the Holy Ghost, but also for those that just needs to make a new commitment to God that says, "Lord, I want to go. I want to be a man or a woman of action. I will go. Lord Jesus, God, help me to be a witness." You know, if you'll pray that God will open the doors, and if you'll take that step of faith, God will always make a way for you to be a witness. "I will go. I will do my part. I'm going to keep praying and fasting. Don't get me wrong, Pastor. But boy, there's somebody in my neighborhood, there's somebody in my family that needs to hear the gospel, that needs to hear the plan of salvation, would you go, church? Would you make that new landmark, that new commitment? Would you build it tonight? Would you say, Lord, here I am. Speak through me, Lord. This week, tomorrow, tonight, God, open that door. Would you just pray tonight, church, as we sing this chorus? Let the Lord speak to you. Let Him deal with your heart. In your little world, there's somebody that needs to hear the truth. Let it be you. Go. Go. Hallelujah, Jesus.
You can use anything, Lord. You can use me. You can use anything, Lord. You can use me. Take my hands, Lord. Take my feet. Touch my heart, Lord. Speak through me. You can use anything, Lord. You can use me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. If you can use anything, Lord, you can use me. Take my hands, Lord, take my feet. Touch my heart, Lord, speak through me. You can use anything, Lord, you can use me. You can use anything, Lord, you can use me. You can use anything, Lord, you can use me.